Thank you. Please remain standing for the faculty anthem.
Sorry, 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 s
Thank you, and please be seated. Light and brightness has always been linked with positivity and motivation. To move along with the traditions, let us bless the new start by lighting the oil lamp. For that, I cordially invite the Vice Chancellor of the University of Peradeniya, Professor Upul B. Disanayake, the Deputy Vice Chancellor, Professor Parakrama Karunaratna, the Dean of the Faculty of Science, Professor Saluka Kodithuakku, the Dean of the Professor Gamini Pushpakumara, to represent all other deans, Professor Sudharma Yatigammana, to represent all heads of the departments of the Faculty of Science, Acting Registrar, Mr. Saman Rajapaksa, Bursa, Mr. EARM Edirisingha, Acting Librarian, Mr. R. Maheshwaran, Proctor, Dr. Nanda Balasurya, Deputy Proctor, Dr. Ashwini Amarasingha, the Chairperson of the Organizing Committee, Dr. Rekha De Silva, Assistant Registrar, Faculty of Science, Ms. Jeevanti Disanayake, Assistant Bursa, Faculty of Science, Ms. Chaturani Senanayake, President of the Science Student Union, Mr. Tharaka Manigasekara, and a girl and a boy from the new intake. And also Professor Demeter Weber, from the director of the Thank you, and please be seated.
Have a certain rough idea about what the university system is. When we consider in the normal society is mainly based on wealth, ethnicity, races, religious, like those things. But in the university system, in the university society, we have refused those things and we have focused a social system with based on brotherhood. So, although this might be a very happy full day for all of you, it is fair to have a confuse in your mind because of some news created by various people and various media about the ragging and those things. But as the president of the Science Student Union, we can certify that there will be no ragging or neither violence in our faculty. So instead of that, we have planned a system to create your brotherhood with each among. So as the president of Science Student Union, I warmly welcome to you all to Faculty of Science. Thank you.
Upakulapathumani, niyojya upakulapathumani, පීඨාධිපතිතුමනි, ඒ වගේම පැමිණ සිටින ගෞරවනීය ආචාර්යතුමනි, ආචාර්යතුමියනි, අනද්දෙන සේවක මහත්මාත්මින් වගේම අද දවසේ මේ ස්ථානයට එන්න හැකියාව ලැබපු පෙරදෙනි විශ්වවිද්‍යාලයේ 2018 වසර කණ්ඩායමේ ආදරණීය සහෝදරවරුනි, සහෝදරියනි, ඒ වගේම පෙරදෙනි විශ්වවිද්‍යාලයේ විද්‍යාපීඨයේ පළමු දෙවන තෙවන සිවුවන වසර කණ්ඩායමේ ආදරණීය සහෝදරත්වයන් වගේම අද දවසේ නවීන තාක්ෂණය ඔස්සේ අපි දිහා බලාගෙන අපේ කතාව අහගෙන ඉන්න ආදරණීය දෙමව්පියනි ඔබ සියලු දෙනාගෙන් අවසරයි. විශේෂයෙන්ම අපි අහලා තියෙනවා කතාවක්, අපි අහලා තියෙනවා කියමනක් ඉගෙනීම කටුවත් එකි එහි ඵලයේ මල්ලිත් එක් කියලා. ඉතින් ඒ මගේ යමින් වසර 13ක පාසල් ජීවිතය, පාසල් අධ්‍යාපනය හමාර කරලා විශ්වවිද්‍යාලය කියන භූමියට එහෙම නැත්නම් එතනින් ඉදිරි කඩේම පියමනින්නට සමත්කම් ලබන ඉතාම සුළු පිරිසක් විදියට ඔබ සියලු දෙනා විශ්වවිද්‍යාලයේ භූමියට පැමිණීමට භාග්‍ය ලැබිලා තියෙනවා. අපි සමාජ ආර්ථිකවීමට අනුව කියනවා සමාජයේ සාරය කියලා විශ්වවිද්‍යාල ශිෂ්‍යයා. එතකොට අද දවසේ ඒ සමාජයේ සාරය විදියට ඔබ සියලු දෙනාට විශ්වවිද්‍යාල භූමියට එන්න වාසනාව ලැබිලා තියෙනවා. විශේෂම අපි හිතන ඔබට දල අදහසක් ඇති කියලා විශ්වවිද්‍යාලය කියන්නේ මොකද්ද කියන එක අපි දැකලා තියෙනවා. බාහිර සමාජය ගත්තොත් එහෙනම් බාහිර සමාජයේ විශේෂයෙන්ම ජාතිය කුලය ඒ දේවල් අනුව ભેද වෙලා වර්ග වෙලා තමයි සමාජය තියෙන්නේ. හැබැයි අපි විශ්වවිද්‍යාලය ඇතුලේ ඊට වඩා වෙනස් ක්‍රමයක් ස්ථාපිත කරලා තියෙනවා, ඊට වඩා වෙනස් ව්‍යුහයක් ස්ථාපිත කරලා තියෙනවා. විශ්වවිද්‍යාලය ඇතුලේ ජාතිය කුලය කියන දේවල්, ආගම කියන දේවල්, භාෂාව කියන දේවල් දෙවෙනිකොට අපි සියලු දෙනා සහෝදරත්වයෙන් සලකලා සියලුම දෙනා එකම සහෝදර කණ්ඩායමක් විදියට සලකලා තමයි කටයුතු කරන්නේ. ඉතින් හැබැයි අපි දන්නවා මොනවා වුණත් මේ සියලු දෙනා මේ වෙනකොට බාහිර සමාජයේ ඉඳලා අවුරුදු 20ක් තිස්සේ ඔබේ සමාජයේ තියෙන ගතිගුණත් එක්ක පෝෂණය වෙලා තමයි අද දවසේ මේ ස්ථානට ඇවිල්ලා තියෙන්නේ. එතකොට සමහර දේවල් තියෙනවා ඔබට විශ්වවිද්‍යාල භූමියේ ඉන්නකොට අත්හරින්න සිද්ධ වෙන දේවල්. බාහිර සමාජයෙන් ගෙනාවු සමහර අගතිගාමි ලක්ෂණ තියෙනවා විශ්වවිද්‍යාල භූමියට ගැලපෙන්නේ නැති. ඒ සමග ඒ දේවල් ගැන කතා කරන්න, ඒ දේවල් සමග සංවාද කරන්න අපි ඉදිරියේදී ඔබත් සමග එක් වෙන්න සූදානම් ඉන්නවා. ඒ වගේම අපි මෙතන ගත්තොත් එහෙම රටේ උතුරු කරේ ඉඳලා දකුණු කරේ දක්වාත්, නැගෙනහිර බටහිර දක්වාත් සියලුම සතර දිග් භාගයේ සහෝදර සහෝදරියන් මේ ස්ථානයට අද ඇවිල්ලා ඉන්නවා. එතකොට අපි ගත්තොත් මෙතන ඉන්න සියලු දෙනාගේ සාමූහිකව ගත්තොත් භාෂාව වෙන්න පුළුවන්, සංස්කෘතින් වෙන්න පුළුවන්, එහෙම නැත්නම් තමන්ගේ ආගමික දේවල් ඒ ඇදහිලි වෙන්න පුළුවන්, ඒ සියලු දේවල් එකිනෙකට වෙනස් දේවල් වෙන්න පුළුවන්. හැබැයි ඒ සියලු වෙනස්කම් කැටි කරගෙන සාමූහිකව එක ගුණාංගයක් යටතේ එක පොදු විහිළුවක් විදියට අපි ඉදිරියට ඔබත් එක්ක කටයුතු කරන්න බලාපොරොත්තු වෙමින් ඉන්නවා. ඒ වගේම අද දවසේ ඔබට මේක ගොඩක් සොඳුරු දවසක් වුණාට විශේෂයෙන්ම තමන්ගේ අධ්‍යාපන කඩේම පහු කරන්න උසස් අධ්‍යාපන වරම හිමි කරගන්න පුළුවන් වුණ අවස්ථාව වුණාට ඔබේ හිතේ සමහරට චකිතයක් තියෙන පුළුවන් විශ්වවිද්‍යාල තුල විශේෂයෙන්ම පහුගිය කාලේ කතාබහට ලක් වුණ නවකෝදේ වැනි කාරණා සම්බන්ධයෙන්. විශේෂයෙන්ම එකක් තමයි අපි කියන්න ඕනේ මේ වෙනකොට පහුගිය දවස් කීපයේ විශ්වවිද්‍යාල උසස් පෙළ විභාගයේ ප්‍රතිඵල නිකුත් වුණා. ඒකත් එක්ක ඇත්තටම පෞද්ගලික විශ්වවිද්‍යාලට බඳවා ගන්න විශාල වශයෙන් එවැනි කුමන්ත්‍රණකාරී වැඩ වෙනවා. එතකොට විශ්වවිද්‍යාලවල තුල නවකෝදේ පවතිනව වැනි කාරණා සම්බන්ධයෙන් විශාල සංවාද ඉදිරි දිනවල ගොඩනැගෙන්න පුළුවන්. මොකද එකක් තමයි ඔබ සතුටු වෙන්න ඕනේ, අපි දන්නවා මේ ලංකාවේ අධ්‍යාපන ක්‍රමය තුල පෞද්ගලික විශ්වවිද්‍යාලයකට යන්න උත්සාහ කරලා බැරි වෙලා රාජ්‍ය විශ්වවිද්‍යාලයක විදිහට මෙතනට ආපු කිසිම කෙනෙක් මං හිතනවා නැතුව ඇති කියලා. හැබැයි ඒකේ අනිත් පැත්තට වෙන ඕන්තරම් පිරිස ඉන්නවා. ඒ කියන්නේ රාජ්‍ය විශ්වවිද්‍යාලයකට එන්න උත්සාහ කරලා බැරි වෙලා අසාර්ථක වෙලා අවසාන පෞද්ගලික විශ්වවිද්‍යාලයට ගිහිල්ලා මේ රාජ්‍ය විශ්වවිද්‍යාල පද්ධතිය අකර්මණ්‍ය කරන්න අවශ්‍ය එක එක ප්‍රකාශනිකුත් කරන පුද්ගලයෝ මාධ්‍ය වගේ දේවල් තියෙන පුළුවන්. ඒතකොට විශේෂයෙන්ම අපි දෙමාපියන්ටත් කියනවා අපි මොකක් හරි ඔබට ගැටලුවක් තියෙනවා නම් ඇත්තටම අපි සම්බන්ධ කරගෙන කතා කරන්න පුළුවන්. ඒ සම්බන්ධයෙන් අපි ඔබට අවස්ථාව සලසා දීලා තියෙනවා. ඒ වගේම කියන්න ඕනේ එකක් තමයි, කියන්නේ ඔබ විශ්වවිද්‍යාල භූමියට ආවට පස්සේ මීට කලින් ඔබ අධ්‍යයන කටයුතු වල විතරක් නිරත වෙලා ඉන්නේ නැති. ඇත්තටම විශ්වවිද්‍යාලය කියන්නේ එහෙම භූමියක් නෙමෙයි. විශ්වවිද්‍යාලය කියන්නේ අධ්‍යයන කටයුතු වගේම කලාව, ක්‍රීඩාව, සාහිත්‍ය ඒ වගේ සියලුම කටයුතු සමාන්තරව කරගෙන යන්න ඕනේ පරිසරයක්. ඉතින් ඔබ ඒ සියලුම කටයුතු සමාන්තරව කරගෙන යන්න නැත්නම් ඇත්තටම ඔබේ ලොකු දුර්වලතාවක් තියෙනවා. ඒ වගේම අපි කියන්න කැමති අපේ එක්තරා ආචාර්යතුමෙක් කියපු කතාවක් තියෙනවා. විශ්වවිද්‍යාල උපාධි වර්ග එකක් නෙමෙයි, විශ්වවිද්‍යාල උපාධි වර්ග දෙකක් තියෙනවා. එකක් අපි කියනවා 8 ඉඳන් 5 වෙනකම් උපාධිය, අනිකට කියනවා අපි හවස 5න් පස්සේ උපාධිය කියලා. 8 ඉඳන් 5 වෙනකම් උපාධිය කියන්නේ අපි ගන්න අධ්‍යාපන තුලින් ලබා ගන්න, අපි ගන්න දැනුම තුලින් ලබා ගන්න උපාධිය. ඒ වගේම ඒ උපාධියට අමතරව අර කියපු ක්‍රීඩාව, කලාව, සාහිත්‍ය වගේ ගුණාංග දිනු කරලත් නැවත උපාධියක් ඔබ මේ විශ්වවිද්‍යාල භූමියෙන් පිටව යන්න කලින් සම්පූර්ණ කරගෙන යා යුතුව තියෙනවා. එහෙම නැත්නම් ඔබ සමාජයට යද්දී එක් ගුණාංගයක් විතරක්, එක් කොටසක් විතර සම්පූර්ණ කරගත ශිෂ්‍යෙක් විදිහට විශ්වවිද්‍යාලෙන් එළියට යනවා නම් ඔබ සම්පූර්ණ විද්‍යාර්ථියෙක් විදිහට සමාජයට යන්න බෑ කියන ආකල්පය තමයි අපේ තියෙන්නේ. ඒ වගේම ඔබට ඒ කටයුතු වල නිරත වෙද්දී ඉදිරියේදී ඒ කටයුතු වල නිරත වෙන්න කොහොමද කියන මාර්ගෝපදේශනයේ මඟ පෙන්වීම අපි කරන්න කැමැත්තෙන් ඉන්නවා. ඒ වගේම විශේෂයෙන්ම දෙමාපියන්ටත් වචනයක් ආමන්ත්‍රණය කරන්න ඕනේ. විශේෂයෙන්ම ඉදිරි දිනකදී සමහරට ඔබේ සෙවනේ අවුරුදු ගණනාවක් හැදුන වෙන දරුවා සමහරට ඔබෙන් මිදිලා ඔබෙන් ඈත් වෙලා වෙනත් පරිසරයකට යන්න සිද්ධ වෙනවා. හැබැයි අපි කියනවා මෙතන ඉන්න සමහර දෙනාට අද දවසේ යාළුවෙක් නැතුව ඇති. හැබැයි ඔබ සියලු දෙනාට ඉදිරි දවසකදී ඉදිරි කාලයක් ඇතුළත මේ සියලු දෙනාම තමන්ගේ සහෝදරයෝ වගේම මේ සියලු දෙනාගේ අම්මල තාත්තලා තමන්ගේ අම්මල තාත්තලා වෙන විදිහට වගේම ඒ විදිහට අපි මේ ඔබ විශ්වවිද්‍යාල සමාජයට හැඩගස්වන්න සූදානමින් ඉන්නවා ඒ සමග ඒ පිළිබඳව ඔබ සමග සංවාද කරන්න බලාපොරොත්තු වෙනවා ඉතින් ඒ කාරණා මතක් කරමින් විද්‍යාපීඨ ශිෂ්‍ය සංගමයේ විදිහට අද දවසේ පෙරදෙන විශ්වවිද්‍යාලයේ විද්‍යාපීඨය அனைவருக்கும் எனது காலை வணக்கம் பேராதினி பல்கலைக்கழகத்தின் விஞ்ஞான பீட்டத்துக்கு காலாபிபடுத்து வைத்து இருக்கும் சகோதர
Very good morning to everybody. Professor Pulpi Dishanayaka, Vice Chancellor of the University of Proctor Dr. Nanda Balasuriya, the Deputy Proctor Dr. Ashwini Amarasingha, Assistant Registrar of the Faculty of Science, Assistant Bursar of the Faculty of Science, invited guests, the parents and students. The first of all, I would like to welcome you all official opening of this newly constructed auditorium of the Faculty of Science. The Deputy Vice Chancellor, sir, I warmly welcome you, and not only as the Deputy Vice Chancellor, but also welcome you as the former Dean of this faculty, and because I already mentioned that this is the newly constructed auditorium, you are the main force behind this, and therefore I warmly welcome you for this inauguration ceremony as well as the opening of the auditorium. The fellow deans, the always we all together welcome the new entrance to the University of Peradeniya, and you also gathered here today to welcome the new intake of science, the invited guest. I warmly welcome you all to the inauguration ceremony of year 2020. Dear parents and students, on behalf of the Faculty of Science, University of Peradeniya, it gives me a great pleasure to welcome you all to the family of science students, University of Peradeniya. Today, I am here together with our Vice Chancellor, Deputy Vice Chancellor, and then all the key officials of the University of Peradeniya, together with the academic staff members and the non-academic staff members and the senior students of the faculty to welcome you all. And then, as already mentioned, you are a lucky bunch of students who got an opportunity to admit to the most beautiful, largest, and the number one ranked university of the Sri Lanka. At the Faculty of Science, we always offer the quality degree programs such a way that once you successfully complete your degree programs, you will be able to join any sector of the country. I know. When you are informed that you have been selected to the Faculty of Science, you might feel disappointed. Because when you sat for the A-level examination, probably you aim at the Faculty of Engineering or Faculty of Medicine. But anyway, today you are here to join the family of science. If you successfully complete the degree programs offered by our faculty, that means you will be able to become a true scientist. If you become a true scientist, you will get opportunity. And then your opportunities are vast. You will be able to work with scientists of the faculties like engineering, medicine, and other faculties available in this university. This university has 9 faculties. No other university has such a number of faculties. And then you have an opportunity to live within this society with your success. But I have to mention one thing during the fast. What we have noticed is students hardly come and discuss their problems with the staff members. Each one of you will be assigned 2 academic staff members as academic advisors. I have to mention this today. The main purpose of assigning academic advisors to help you, and then also, if necessary, provide the counseling. And as the dean of the faculty, I will not entertain you if you come with someone else, or maybe one of your friend who is in the senior batches, and if you come with them and talk to me without coming through the academic advisor, usually I don't like to listen to you. You are adults, that means the 20 years old young men and women, and therefore you should be able to come forward and express your ideas, problems, or whatever you have to your academic advisors or to me. Then why I tell that you have to come through the academic advisors? Because the reason is students hardly listen to our advice. Every year, on the first day of the academic program, well, that means for you, today we address you and then we allow you to go and register for the register as the students of the Faculty of Science, and then the February 5th, that is the next month, we will start your academic program, and then on that day onwards, we will be behind you to help you, but it is your responsibility to get that help and then use the abilities and then the qualifications, skills and whatever available within the faculty. And if you do not do that, then finally you will suffer. And because of that reason, please keep in mind all the necessary advices regarding the planning of your academic program and then the progress of your academic program towards the completion of your academic program will be provided throughout your stay here. And then you have to participate in those advisory sessions and whatever the sessions organized by the faculty, and then use those things for your success, or in particular to develop your career. And also, your senior fellow, that means the president of the Faculty of Science Union, already mentioned that they look after you without the ragging, and then as the academic staff members of the faculty as well as the University of Peradeniya, we want University of Peradeniya to be zero ragging place. Well, that means no harassment to the juniors. It may be any form, physical harassment, sexual harassment, or verbal harassment. Nothing will be accepted. Help them, and then you will also be punished. Or simply speaking, the discipline is the vital factor for the Faculty of Science. Are available within the faculty, and then you have to use them in order to complete your respective academic programs while preserving them for the future generation. So that means when you use the physical resources available within the faculty, you have to keep in mind once you get out from this place, there are large number of students are awaiting to get into the university and continue their higher studies. And therefore, you have to preserve those resources for the future generation. Before the commencement of your academic program, the faculty provide you the faculty handbook, which include all the rules and regulations of the university, as well as the examination bylaws and other things approved by the university and the faculty, and then you have to follow all those rules and regulations during your stay at University of Peradeniya. And once again, the welcoming you all to the Faculty of Science, University of Peradeniya, and congratulating you all for getting selected to the most beautiful, largest, and the number one ranked University of Sri Lanka, I wish you all the best in your future studies. Thank you very much.
Thank you, sir, for that motivational words and the valuable advices given.
Deputy Vice Chancellor. First of all, as usual, I would like to welcome as the Vice Chancellor all of you to this prestigious university. And at the same time, I would like to congratulate on your achievement that you have got an opportunity to enter into the Faculty of Science, especially in Peradeniya. As you all know, as your parents know, during last 13 years, you have gone through a very difficult period. In one way, rather, I would say that is a self-mortification. Not only you, your parents as well. At the end of that self-mortification, you have got an opportunity to enter to the University of Peradeniya. That is one of the fortunate things that can happen in your life, because at the beginning when you enter into the Faculty of Science, you would have heard various school stories. Are you going to end up your career as a school teacher? That is not the case, I must explain you. People who have short-sighted people will say like that. But really speaking, science is the base for everything in this world. Whatever the specific disciplines, maybe medicine, those who are coming to do medicine, they will be ended up as doctors. Those who are coming to do BDS, they will end up as dentists. Those who are coming to do BBSC, those who are, we know who they are, who they are going to be. But about you, we don't know who you are going to be in the future. So from a school teacher to the chief scientist in NASA, spectrum is broad. There is no limitation for you all. Depending your devotion, dedication and commitment, the world is open for you. Therefore, you will decide your position that you are going to acquire in the future, not like others. When there is a dentist, we know they are going to be dentists. We don't know who you are going to be. That is the special thing in science. Sky is not the limit for you all. Therefore, there is nothing for you to discourage. You have to work hard and try to achieve whatever the goals that you have. Administration also, from Gram Sevaka to the DIG or chief of the presidential secretary. The spectrum is unlimited for you all. Therefore, I think you are really well lucky to be a science student, especially in Peradeniya. That is one of the things. So, next thing is all of us, including me and you, have come here because of free education. Free education is a misnomer, really speaking. It's not free. Someone else is paying for this your education. If they did not pay for your education, if they are not going to pay for your education, you are not going to be here, as well as you are not going to be students in this university. Who they are the people of this country. Please remember that. And with all these, as we all are aware that in this moment, country is going through a very difficult period in terms of economy. Therefore, all of us, to be happy with what we have and admire what we have, appreciate what we have got from free education. Now, until you qualify from this university, everything, most of the things will be given free. You will be given a room for 62 rupees per term. Where else you can get a room like that? You won't get a room like you are getting in a room. You know, it's not like a room from the Hilton. But still, you must understand our situation in the country, and we must be happy about what we are going to get. meals. Once you come to meals, you are not going to get a sophisticated, very rich meal, but for 35 or 40 rupees or maximum of 50 rupees, you are going to get a ඔබ අද ඇතුළු වෙන විශ්වවිද්‍යාලයේ ජාතික සහ ජාත්‍යන්තර වශයෙන් පිළිගැනීමක් තියෙන විශ්වවිද්‍යාලය. ඒක නිසා මම මේ ගැන හරි ආඩම්බරයෙන් සඳහන් කරන ඔබ සියලු දෙනාට ඔබ අපි සියලු දෙනා ඉදිරි ජයග්‍රහණ සහ මේ විශ්වවිද්‍යාලය තවදුරටත් ඉදිරියට ගෙන යාම ඔබ සියලු දෙනාගේ වගකීම සහ යුතුකම වෙනවා. ඔබ ලබන ජයග්‍රහණ තමයි විශ්වවිද්‍යාලයේ ජයග්‍රහණ වෙන්නේ. ඒක නිසා I hope you all will understand that as well. Now again, I must say that you have come to a university where this is a residential university where most of us, 75% of the students will get residence inside. That is one of on stature. You won't get that opportunity once you go out. Therefore, and at the same time, in terms of facilities, those are not luxury. These 4 years, not only for education but extracurricular activities as well, because to become a comprehensive or comprehensive personality, or what we expect from you is to go out with all these skills and not only with knowledge but skills as well. So that is another thing I want to tell you all. And at the same time, as I already mentioned, university is not different from the other world. All other cruel forces as well as unwanted things are around. There is a good side as well as the bad side also. So drugs, alcohol, smoking, and I know you are knowledgeable, you are educated, but there is something missing in you. That is life skills or exposure to the society is not there. Because that is not a fault of you. You didn't have a time. University until within that 20 years you haven't had an opportunity to expose into the public. In this world, in this society, you have to have life skills. Now you are independent, but still you have to say yes, you are going to open up your new chapter in your life where you are going to write your chapter on your own. All these days your parents were behind you. You couldn't write as you wished. Now today, from today onwards, therefore there is a possibility, especially and we can then only you can go. You must keep your objectives first. Don't try to fix others' objectives as your objectives. You have come here to go as a graduate. Skills, they will not select you for anything. Therefore, this 4 years, if you use it in the maximum possible way, so you can have a comfortable life for the rest of your life. If you try to If you mess up these 4 years, so your future is going to be the rest of the life is going to be spoiled. Please remember that. That is very important. And again, I'm not going to extend my speech more than that. I have given in you the messages that I wanted to give, and then finally the ragging. We don't have something called ragging now. We name, you know, it is recognized as human torture. There is no human torture, as this student leader promised. There is no human torture in Peradeniya. Nobody will get involved in that. I think that as students, as teachers, as student union people, and so on, so we don't know who they are. Please be careful. We have to be, even I should be careful. Said, and there is no torture in Peradeniya, there is no ragging in Peradeniya. We are ready to face that ragging this time in a different capacity, in a different way. Maybe sometimes for the first time in the life you are leaving your child alone and going back home within 1 or 2 years, 1 or 2 hours time. May not going to be a graduate, because if they deviate from the education, so we can't guarantee anything. Therefore, please be with them for the rest of the 2 years. Then at the end of 4 years, you can be happy, we can be happy, all of us can be happy. Having said that, finally, I would like to wish all of you a successful 4 years in Peradeniya, 3 or 4 years in Peradeniya, not more than that. Thank you.
Thank you very much, sir, for that encouraging words. The University of Peradeniya boasts about its rich culture and holds many traditions that are passed to generations with much pride. The students of the Arts Circle of the Faculty of Science are now ready to showcase their talents. Please give them a round of applause and welcome them on stage. Hope you enjoyed those beautiful performances by our very own students, the students of the Art Circle of the Faculty of Science. To mark the conclusion of the inauguration ceremony, I invite Dr. Rekha De Silva, the chair.
will be Disanayake, the Vice Chancellor of University of Peradeniya, for gracing this occasion despite his busy schedule. Your presence here is a great encouragement and a blessing to us. Next, I wish to thank Professor Parakrama Karunaratna, the Deputy Vice Chancellor of University of Peradeniya, for joining us this morning in spite of his heavy workload. I wish to thank all the special invitees for spending their valuable time to be here with us. Your presence here is a great honor to us. Also, I wish to extend my sincere gratitude to Professor Saluka Kodithuakku, Dean, Faculty of Science, for his guidance, encouragement, and all the support given to us in organizing this event. A special thank goes to heads of all departments of the Faculty of Science for their invaluable support extended in many ways in this in organizing this event successfully. Also, all the academic staff, temporary academic staff, academic support staff, and non-academic staff members of the Faculty of Science are gratefully acknowledged for supporting us in numerous ways in organizing this event. Without all your support, this event would have not been a success. Further, I wish to thank the members of the Science Student Union for their support given to make this event a success. Faculty of Science and the staff of the Dean's Office, Faculty of Science, for the enormous support given in organizing this event. I also wish to extend my gratitude to the students this event. My special thanks goes to director and staff from the Network and Communication Services Unit.
vision is to be a globally renowned faculty of science, contributing towards the development of a vibrant scientific community. Our mission is to promote excellence in education, training, research outreach activities in the basic and applied sciences, and to organize and conduct such programs to support national development. Presently, the faculty consists of 8 academic departments and 2 units, namely Department of Botany, Chemistry, Geology, Mathematics, Molecular Biology and Biotechnology, Physics, Statistics and Computer Science, Zoology, Computer Unit and Science Education Unit. The Faculty of Science offers course of study leading to General and Special Bachelor of Science (BSc) degrees. The faculty at present offers special degree programs in botany, chemistry, computer science, geology, mathematics, molecular biology and biotechnology, physics, statistics and zoology. General degree students may at the end of third year be selected based on performance and given the option of following courses for an additional year with special emphasis on industry-related courses, leading to a degree in BSc Applied Sciences in place of a general degree. The faculty also conducts 4-year BSc degree programs in computation and management and in statistics and operations research for students. Other services provided by the faculty administration are library facilities, residence, sports and recreation, medical center, student counseling, banking facilities, canteen, post office and telephone exchange, barber saloon, laundry and tailoring shop, police and security service. After completion of degrees that offer from Faculty of Science, students may have a higher chance to qualify for Central Bank, Harbor, Airlines, Defense Authority in government sector, while whole industry is open for students in private sector. Easily enroll for higher studies in Sri Lankan or foreign universities such as USA, UK, Canada, Australia, etc. with scholarships opportunities.